Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
I got a bunch of other news I want to intersperse in this hour, but I want to hear from veterans and active duty only. We got good phones. I want to hear from you right now. What do you think of the police departments everywhere publicly training that you're terrorist and that they will have a war with you? I mean, this isn't even 2 + 2 = 4. This is just 1 + 1 = 2. This is open treason being prepared for. How do you think we stop it? How do we get this information out? The story's red linked up at Infowars.com. Police now arming for against returning veterans, and it just says it all. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. You get our articles, our police state films. You give them to local police departments and sheriff's departments. If you golf with the local, you know, police chief or the cops, talk to them. Get them off their little, you know, power trip that they're the good guys and, you know, the feds are good and all this. They need to wake up and see the wider picture. Just because they're good guys and actually aren't corrupt doesn't mean they're not being given a corrupt mission in the future and that the preparation for treason isn't there like a foreign army lining up on your border. Toll-free number for veterans and active duty. I want to hear from you. You won't have to hold long. I'm going to go to you quickly. 800-259-9231. And that's it. 800-259-9231. John Bowne just walked in here during the break. And he said, one of the producers, he said, is it just me or is Kerry and Holder both pushing for World War III? Yeah, they're both just constantly pushing for war with Russia. You've got tanks and armored vehicles and helicopters attacking the Russian-held areas that have always been Russian. And again, I'm not romanticizing the Russians. That's the word. I'm not romanticizing it. The West is starting this. George Soros is generaling or captaining the whole thing. I mean, it's just, it's Twilight Zone level. It's Twilight Zone level. They have used the openness of our society to bring in this garbage. Here's a headline up on Drudge. GOP takes on Michelle O's lunch rules. Yeah, my kids were going to private school a couple years ago. They homeschool fully now. And it was a good school, but to be accredited, it was like handouts from Michelle Obama every few months and like telling the kids what was good to eat. It was like horrible GMO Lunchables and stuff. House Republicans are proposing to let schools opt out of healthier school lunch. I mean, it's like prison food now. It's worse than food I've had in jail the times I've been arrested as a protester. Never convicted me. I mean, I've been quite a few times in the Hooskow for stuff. And I was in juvenile a couple times because there'd be a big fight. And, you know, somebody goes to the hospital, they take you to jail regardless, and you're in there over the weekend. And, you know, I mean, it was prison food is better than what they feed in the schools. Why not? Parents put up with it. And now they're saying parents can't bring the lunches under DHS, under Michelle, Health and Human Services. You know what, in Denver and Chicago, the school districts are saying, parents, you can't be trusted. Oh, they use allergies. You might put peanuts in so you can't be trusted. Yeah, because we're so sickly now from GMO that it triggers people's allergies. So kids are like invalids now. Pretty soon, half the kids will be dying. Pediatric cancer is already up over 10,000% on average. Look it up. And the answer will be, we have GMO patties for your kid. You can't pack a lunch for your prisoner. Hell, even in most prisons, they let family bring you food when they visit. Not anymore. Maximum security for our children, ladies and gentlemen, with select insider groups. In fact, I remember we showed some photos a while back of, if you just type in Michelle school food prisoners, and it'll show it next to prisoner food and then shots of it. It's unbelievable. All right, your calls coming up. I'd like to hear from some police, too. I mean, I know you're all training that the vets are going to kill you any minute. And I guess when they blow stuff up and blame it on the vets and try to arrest a bunch of them, the vets will fight back. They won't go to the FEMA camp, and it'll be self-fulfilled. Look, they're terrorists. So I guess we're just too stupid to stop this civil war. I guess that's what people want. People hate the vets so much they want war with them.
chemical spill contaminating the water supply in 9 West Virginia counties.
This year alone, over 300,000 people in West Virginia had their drinking water contaminated.
What are the health effects of having these drugs in our drinking water?
It's forced medical treatment without the consent of residents.
My friends, water filtration is one of the most basic actions you can take to protect you and your family from the harmful toxins and heavy metals in your tap water.
On average, the county says it sprays with glyphosate at least once a week.
Few filters cut out the glyphosates that is found in water supplies worldwide. Remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, hydrofluorosilicic acid, sodium hexafluorosilicate.
Fluoride, it is in tea, it's in coffee, it's in water, it's in bread, it's in toothpaste.
It is our responsibility to protect our families. The establishment's not going to do it. It's time to take action. It's time to filter our water. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and use promo code WATER to get 10% off their entire family of incredible products. Or call toll-free 888-253-3139. This is Alex Jones for InfoWarsLife.com. The latest in preparedness is now here. An electrically stabilized colloidal silver solution that can be added to both your home cabinet and preparedness pack alike. Concentrated to 30 parts per million. And what has been dubbed the survival silver solution, the new InfoWars Life Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver, is the answer for you and your family. And it's entirely free of toxic artificial additives that are loaded into many products. The InfoWars Life Silver Bullet Silver is so powerful that it is concentrated into a 2-ounce bottle and is not recommended for extended continual use. This is not a low-grade formula. We are working with one of the top laboratory manufacturers in the United States to bring you the best form of colloidal silver using electrical processes within a base of deionized water for your preparedness storage or your home kitchen. Purchase your bottle of InfoWarsLife.com Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver today and find other amazing supplements at InfoWarsLife.com. From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
All right, I just spent a lot of the first hour interspersing other important news, but covering police now armed for war against returning veterans. And I've been harping on this on Sunday's show and now today. And we're live broadcasting worldwide on the 19th day of May 2014. Coming up at the bottom of the hour, she's just with us for 10 minutes. We'll continue back to calls. The niece of Dr. Martin Luther King, Alveda King, is coming on to talk about abortion genocide in this country and what's really happening. She's with Press for Life, so she's going to be joining us. We appreciate her joining us today. But let me just play part of the newscast, where in the newscast, it's a 5.5-minute newscast up on InfoWars.com and DrudgeReport.com, also has a link in the middle column, that, oh, we got to have these giant wheeled tanks because the veterans are coming home. We've always had veterans coming home and didn't need tanks rolling around in small towns. Here it is.
They're your tax dollars at work, and instead of being blown up, scrapped, or given away to a foreign country, surplus U.S. military hardware is coming home from the war.
Hit pause. Back. Let's start from the beginning again. Why not nerve gas then? I mean, we've got hundreds of thousands of gallons at bases everywhere, probably millions of gallons total of nerve gas, VX and sarin. Well, why doesn't the Pentagon spray that on America? I mean, we don't want to waste it. And I said this going back a decade ago when they were buying these armored vehicles and right through to an order just a few years ago for thousands more. They're making them, they're manufacturing them, and they're just rolling around now. You'll come to a checkpoint and the cops will have one while they're searching cars with a machine gun on your car. It's all training us to be an occupied country. This is the rollout. And all over the country, they have military drills that then go live with the Marines and the Army. Remember East St. Louis last year? Where they said, no, this is martial law. This has been going on for a long time, but it's building up and accelerating. Let's go back to the newscast.
They're your tax dollars at work, and instead of being blown up, scrapped, or given away to a foreign country, surplus U.S. military hardware is coming home from the wars, being assigned to the streets and back roads of central Indiana to keep Hoosiers safe.
Oh.
Time of escalating homeland violence.
Good pause. Now, this is all scripted. If I had to bet, it was written by Homeland Security Justice Department, maybe Southern Poverty Law Center. They keep saying in a time of escalating violence, in a time of escalating crime, and the cop later says, the head of the SWAT team, because, you know, of all this horrible violence, the veterans, none of that's true. But, and then they roll out the old 70s SWAT show when they popularize everybody's got to have a SWAT team. This is how they program the public. Let's go back to it.
70s TV show SWAT showed state-of-the-art policing when heavily armed cops drove into danger in the back of what was essentially a bread truck. By 2010, for some police departments, not a lot had changed, as the Merrillville Police Department posted a video of its SWAT team in training, riding up to a scenario, clinging to the side of a Chevy Suburban. SWAT team commanders knew there had to be a better way.
Yeah, just kill everybody.
They got one in Martinsville. An excess U.S. Army mine-resistant vehicle, an MRAP, cast off by the American military and parked at the Morgan County Sheriff's Department.
The value of the vehicle was $650,000. It didn't cost us any money at all.
Good pause. They sell it like they're getting something free. This is all a psyop. I've seen literally over the years hundreds of newscasts like this. They've had Marines, Army, you name it, at the checkpoints as well. This is such treason. I'm going to your phone calls in a moment. You know what? The full newscast is up at Infowars.com as we analyze this treason. But let's play the clip of the SWAT team commander who gets to be a military guy and feel like he's a vet while he drives around in the rural area looking for meth labs. I mean, this is a total joke, folks. The government brings in most of the narcotics. Let's go ahead and play the clip of him saying, for the veterans.
When I first started, we really didn't have the violence that we see today. The weaponry is totally different now than it was in the beginning of my career. Plus, you have a lot of people that are coming out of the military that have the ability and the knowledge to build IEDs and to defeat law enforcement.
And he goes on in the full clip. In fact, after we go to your calls, I'm going to play the full clip. Because in the full clip, he says, quote, He goes on to say, quote, we don't want to be outgunned by the veterans. He goes on to say, we were actually approached and asked why we have this. I'm going to put the full interview coming up, but I want to go to your calls. Again, this isn't just in this county. They ordered more than 10,000 extra of these in the last 5-6 years. Before that, in the last decade, they had a bunch of other ones. And they're deploying them everywhere and telling them. Because, folks, I have family that's involved in it, okay? I mean, I knew about this a decade ago. But now it's coming to an head. They're getting ready for something. And it doesn't mean we can't back it down. But they are training to take on mom and apple pie. John Wayne is the enemy. John Deere tractor is the enemy. Your granddaddy's the enemy. They train literally in zombie repulsion attacks. Here's Christian Science Monitor. No prank. On Halloween, U.S. military forces train for zombie apocalypse. And they practice mowing down men, women, and children dressed in rural clothing. We caught video of this previously at Urban Warrior deployments. Those are in my police state films. And so now they go, oh, it's just for zombies. When they practice mowing down crowds of people. That's the cover for it. This is total treason. Mike, Jason, Ernie, Adam, John, we're going to get to all of you right now. Ernie in Tennessee, what is your breakdown on this? They're getting pretty bold. We know it was going on secretly. This shows me they're thinking about going operational.
Yeah, I've got to agree with you, Alex. It looks like they're they're just finally coming out with it. They're just admitting it. And I really hope these police officers wake up.